lot of detail on some of these that you don't see unless you're moving around them. On Monday, these shore sheep for 73 years, and there's the shearer shearing his sheep. I am a sheep, damn it. Like something that there's something out of the magic pudding. Very creative artist nearby here. And there's the shearer doing another sheep. With the machine blades. Over here, a couple of kids. Carolina and Marco. We'll read these. Mary's taking a photograph of all the Italians first came to Hyde in the 1920s. And Johnny the mechanic. Someone has some great imagination. All the bulldozers in the neighbourhood, and they pushed all the trees over, and Dave and Bazza helped bring the main water supply into Hyden. Now there's your tank and that's a well, is it? Is that a well?
No, I don't know what it is. Maybe.
Crane? And here we've got the header. No, power station.
Yeah.
Hyden's first power station.
Yeah.
That's very creative.
Yeah.
I'm not sure whether they actually had a power station like that. Did they?
No, you don't have to put all the time.
Russ and his bus. That's the timeline through Hyden. Yeah, we had a bit of rain around the rose garden here. This is a tribute to the pioneer settlers of Hyden. 50 years of settlement. Down here, this is interesting. The average Joe Blow might miss. There's a time capsule commemorating the ABC's Country Hour. We're going back into the bakery of a meat pie. We're just driving around the block and there's a gum tree growing through the fence, and this shows you how it's reasonably flat terrain here. There's your local transport and your picket fence and your little blue house, and everybody's got, quite a few people have, tons of
bottle brushes
and your Cape lilac tree.
Users' discretion repels.
We are just going to turn the radio off, following the road from Hyden to Lake Grace. Just out through farming country, nice flat wheat stuff, and it's just spitting, just drizzling. This is friendly Lake Grace where we wave at other drivers. Well, it's actually not friendly Lake Grace for a little while. We've just turned from, to follow the railway line down through from Kinglake, something like that. It's the pub. I don't know that it's a great pub. We've just gone through Lake Grace. Just looking down here for the hospital, which is a AIM hospital. I had to argue because the AIM said that, Australian Inland Mission said that it wasn't remote enough.
The Australian Inland Mission Hospital through the rain in Lake Grace. And all around the walkway of murals, other little mosaics. Child. There goes a train past. The lady said you don't see many trains. We looked at the railway crossings and we never saw a sign of a train. Just heard this large deep rumble. Bit of a fluke. Yes, it's a lovely museum now, all restored with its picket fence. The famous Lake Graces that extend all the way along an old river system. There's a pink one just back there.
This is
some of them are very salty. This is South Lake Grace.
Well, I don't know. Maybe.
It rained all day yesterday from Lake Grace down to Pingrup. And it sprinkled all night. We only had a couple of mils. The area had several millimetres. Had an inch or so up north and down the south to Albany. Here's another one of Kevin's economic stimulus packages. That's our third one now. Looks like they put in plastic lawn and paving all around the showers and toilet block where we camped at the $10 caravan park, which was very nice, probably a 2 or 3 star. I only have female toilets though. That's no problem, there's a couple of them. And there's a drain around there. We've seen a few drains for draining the salt in the area. And there's the old silo. It's been superseded by a giant silo. There's the other side of the gully. There's a lovely shearing shed. All the lovely Jarrah stalls.
judge's box.
All the walls are stage. They had poetry readings here, it seems.
Poetry readings?
Yeah, a little while ago. So some poets came up from Albury.
Got a stimulus package, doesn't it?
Albany. Yeah, Albany. There's all the pens there. And the old silo walls. There's the old silo on the outside. And there's the new ones over there. Historical exhibition here. Yeah, that's where my grand uncle died earlier, but no. The 1,000-acre blocks were taken up in 1911. Yeah, carry their water and supplies 40 miles in a wheelbarrow a turn trip. This is our first bridge in WA and it's got water in it. Our first bridge crossing.
The little bridge was just near Borden, one of your giant silos.
Drove along beside.
Biggest grand grain handling silo in WA without a port. They got last year's grain in it. It's been taken off down to Albany as the new stuff comes in.
With the old drive-by, there's the Stirlings coming up a bit closer. Road train just passed us, filled up with grain from Auden. Gordon's the biggest CBH grain storage in Western Australia that's not a port. And they're just emptying out their last year's grain. Helen up river.
Same one.
And it's got water in it.
Look at that.
Yeah,
what?
17 minutes. Ooh!
We're 7K
down. And there's a real actual
wind. I'm almost on top of it, I can hear you very clearly. I'm on top of the hill outside the house. The windmill's just there, and we can look at the outside of it anyway.
Cleverly disguise the traffic behind the lavender here. Helen Peak's got a new track scarring its face. Hopefully it's just an avalanche.
Shaping done, and his wife worked in the hospital while he built it to support the project. It actually, if you get well, it's all done up to the
cap on it. And now we can see the scar on Helen's feet. Going to disappear into the clouds. It's tipping off the road here. There's children up the peak. They climb with Ian Williams. And that's the Bluff Knoll that Mary and I camped up on. Wondering whether I should wait for a photo of Ian Williams and his beetle just about here. We had sunshine on the bluff then. Got a nice gap in the clouds coming up